Hi, this is Gold Jet interviewing Radiant Jet. Gamer Connect brings you this new series called Know Your Streamers. So let's begin with the first episode. Hey guys, so this is Kits and I have with me SK Rossi. Everyone who follows him already know, and you have seen the list of achievements he have done already in the description. For who don't know, please can you introduce yourself?
Hello guys, my name is Ganesh, also known as SK Rossi, and currently I'm playing CSGO for Team Blaze, and I just started streaming on YouTube also, and I just love games, and my past is I represented India once at Indonesia in a game called PS Team Low, which is one of my highest achievement I consider, since I represented my country at the higher level. So I hope to do the games I'm playing right now.
So when did you start YouTube, and how's your journey so far?
I think it's been a month I started streaming. I just do it for fun and try to be myself, to interact with people, and I really want to educate people about esports. Like, there are a lot of people come ask me like how to get into esports, and gaming is the only thing you can do in esports, or there's a lot of other opportunities in esports. So, and I try to help them to see the game in this different perspective, which I see. So that's it. And my viewers also helping me to, you know, overcome whatever mistakes I do in my stream, since I'm new. So I'm positive numbers day by day. So I think I'm going in the right path.
So in Valorant, which map do you hate the most and why?
I hate the map Split.
Same.
I really think it's one-sided for the defenders.
Yeah.
I really that based on the games I've seen in tournaments and on personal experience I've played in PUBG, it's highly advantage for the defenders to play, because all the angles for the attackers to enter are narrow, and they have to come in a bulk and die to one guy in a line of fire. Mm-hmm. If the attackers want to take a part of the map, they should use their all utilities to take only the control of some part of the map, and then without the utilities you also need to enter the site, and it's very hard. So I think I hate the map Split. It's too one-sided.
Sure, there are a lot of beginners who ask you for help, like how to get better and all, and this is the common question with every beginner: how to peek and aim better, how to improve in these two things. So any suggestions for them?
So nothing comes for free. You just have to work hard to improve it. So what I suggest to all my viewers is, whenever they come and ask, I tell them, keep working, keep playing the game, and have an aim routine every day. Like, I suggest them to do any kind of aim routine, like 30 minutes in the morning and before going to sleep, just to keep that muscle memory working whenever you play. DM every time before you play a game. Like, if you want to play PUBG, make sure you do twice DM. And coming to the peak, you just have to play more and more games. To once you start picking the same angles more than like 5-10 times, you'll realize where you're making the mistake and why you're dying. So you just have to do it. But if you ask me personally, a great aim comes from a great game sense, is what I feel, because if you know where the enemy is coming and if you know where the enemy is, it's very easy to aim. So you need to read the opponent. It's not only about aim, it's also about game sense. And when I peek angles, I picture myself in my mind that the enemy will be holding like this. Then I decide whether I have to fight or jiggle peek. So make sure you imagine where the enemy is, or picture in your mind that kind of things will happen. So you'll be aware of it and accordingly.
Like, it's not just about aiming. There are many people who are not really good at aiming, but they can still contribute to the team, right? So there are a lot of things beginners can do if they're not very good at aiming. If you like, they're losing in a 1v1 battle, there's still a lot of things people can do, right? So any tips for these beginners to like get these things out of their mind?
You need to first realize or self-check in what you're good at. Like, considering me, I'm very good at killing people. I like to go ahead, get frags for the team. I have that kind of mentality. If you are the same, go for a duelist, because duelists don't have that much to do. They just have to use utilities for their own. If you like a team minded, if you want to help people to frag, I'll suggest you guys to go like Brimstone or take some heroes which can help, which can which is the hero who not a frontliner, just stay in the back and support. So coming to the utilities, even in CSGO, I personally prefer not to go with utils, just to set the pace to the enemies. I want the enemies to think, okay, this guy is an idiot, he's just coming without a force of flash. And that's where you set the pace for the enemy, and the next round they expect you to come like safe, but I enter with the flash. It's just mind games you have to do. Valorant also, you can sometimes don't make any noise and just go peek the enemy, because that will be expecting, okay, a smoke will come here, a flash will come here, then the enemy will. And don't do what the enemy is expecting always, even if it's an idiot move, even if people say what you're doing is wrong. Unexpected is what I say to the beginners.
So I guess I'll just so, come
to say one thing. Don't, if you're playing games for fun, it's okay, it's your choice. If anyone wants to make it like likes to go pro or like want to really get better at it, always keep track of even one game. You're spending 1 hour. You need to learn something from it. Always set a goal. Like when I play a game, even if I play a game now, I set a goal like, what am I going to do this game? Am I going to win this game on pure aim duels? Or am I going to outsmart the enemies? I have a goal for even one game. I set a goal like, I'm going to play like this and practice this thing. And even if you win, self-check yourself. Why did you win? What good you did in the game that you won the game? And when you lose, you have to keep track of what mistakes you're doing and why you're losing. Improving in it. So don't take even a single game for granted. Keep learning from your mistake. Doing mistakes is the best thing, because you'll learn from it and you won't do it in further games. Work hard, keep playing and learn from whatever you play. Keep asking questions yourself, like what's going on.
There's a lot of smurfing happening. Like, do you think that helps to the get better at the game?
No, I really hate people who create smurfs, because I really feel like it demotivates the people who are in low rank, who are really trying hard, but they won't be knowing it's you smurfing. When they see a diamond or a platinum player like going ham in the game, it kind of demotivates. That's why even after me being Radiant, many people ask me to get a smurf, you won't get game soon when you're Radiant. I said, I really think it kind of unfair, because you're Radiant and if you're playing in the diamond level, it's obviously very easy to win, and I don't know, I think it's unfair. It's okay to make it, but spamming in one smurf, one smurf and after another smurf, like I don't suggest that.
Yeah, true, because I have seen a lot of friends of mine, even they're getting very demotivated because they're probably in silver and they just get destroyed by some other silver. Like, you can see they're not silvers. Anyway, so time for the rapid fire questions. I have 10 questions for you. You just have to answer, like, not why or why you answering that. You just give me the answers. Okay. Yeah. Favorite agent?
Jet.
Favorite map?
Haven.
Nice. Phantom or Vandal?
Phantom.
CSGO or Valorant?
Oh no. Valorant.
Like now, 2020. Infinity is Valorant. Cool. So, which was more difficult for you? Like being a, which is like you felt better? Being a global elite or Radiant?
I never played MM, to be honest, in my 2 years of CSGO. So I think being Radiant is the best feeling I ever got.
Cool. So what do you prefer, wireless mouse or wired mouse?
Wireless. But I don't have one.
Okay. Staying up late gaming or waking up early to play games?
I really want to wake up early and play games, because I feel it's more productive
and healthier, but we all end up doing the other one. Got your point. Okay. Favorite Indian Valorant player?
Ace.
And favorite Indian CSGO player?
Ace.
If penguins were in black and white, what color they would be? There are a lot of people asking you the same question, so I thought it would be nice for you also to now they know the answers. If they want to know tips from Rossi, they can just watch this video. Thank you so much for your time, bro. And that's it, guys. This is it for today's episode. Anything else you want to say to your fans?
I think keep supporting every gamer who's like, who's going pro or who's trying to go pro. Support every streamer. That's it. Let's keep on helping each other and grow.
He streams on YouTube regularly. I'll put his channel link in the description so you can subscribe to his channel. He's an amazing Jett, trust me. I started playing Jett after seeing him, honestly. So that's it. This is me, Kits, signing off for today's video. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, guys.